Hi everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you an updated version of the sales and recurring service tracker I created previously. This tracker is designed for small to medium-sized businesses that provide recurring or scheduled services, especially those that need to track customers, service history, due dates, and sales in one place. Here is a list of businesses that will benefit from this sales and service tracker. I have also added an invoice tracking feature to help manage not only customer service record and sales, but also customer invoices, such as creating invoices and tracking outstanding payments. Now, let me show you how to use this tracker step by step. First, before entering any data into the tracker, go to the Setup tab, set the day of your week begins, choose either Sunday or Monday. Then customize your customer status. You can input status like active, prospect, or inactive. Next, enter your lead sources, which are the ways you acquire customers, such as Facebook ads, Google search, referrals, and more. If English is not your primary language, you can also change the invoice status keywords in the white cells provided. Before using the service record tracker, you will need to enter customer details in the customer list tab. Add information such as customer name, email address, phone number, address, area. Select customer status from the drop-down list. Select lead sources from the drop-down list. Select customer rating. You can rate the customer from 1 star to 5 star. Enter the date they become a customer. Next, go to the item list tab and input the services you offer. For demonstration purposes, I will use a car wash and detailing businesses as an example. Enter the name of the service, a description, price, and frequency in weeks. You can input a dash sign if the service doesn't have a frequency. Once your customer list and item list are set up, you can begin entering data into the service record tracker. In the service record tracker, start by entering the record number, last service date, select customer name from the dropdown, select service name from the dropdown. The green cells will automatically calculate service frequency in week, week number of the last service, and next service due date. Check the box once you have sent a reminder to the customer for the next service. Enter the appointment date, enter the completion date after the job is done, record the total sales amount for the service, enter the invoice number, invoice date, and due date. Check the box once the invoice is sent, enter the amount paid and payment date. The balance column will auto calculate what the customer owes, and the status column will show if the invoice is fully paid, if the balance is zero, partially paid if there is a remaining balance, and unpaid if no payment has been received. All the data entered here will automatically populate in other tabs such as customer overview, item overview, annual overview, due dates overview, overdue service, and outstanding invoices. Now let's move on to the overview tab. First, let's go to customer overviews. Customer overview tab shows a summary of a specific customer. Select the customer name from the drop-down list, and a table will display their service history below. In the top left, you will see a summary including customer status, lead sources, rating, date they became a customer, total services done, outstanding payment, and last service date. The charts on the right display sales breakdown by item, outcoming services, and forecast weekly and monthly sales. Item overview tabs allow you to select an item from the drop-down list to view its service history. Charts on the right show total purchases by customer, weekly and monthly sales. The summary tables include price of the item, frequency, total service done, total sales, outstanding payment, and last service date. The table below will show all the history associated with the selected item name. Next, in the annual overview tab, select the year from the drop-down list to view a monthly breakdown including job completed, sales, amount paid, outstanding balance, and average sales per job. The charts will show the sales versus payment to track collection performance. It will also show the monthly sales and the monthly job completed. At the bottom, tables and charts display number of jobs done per item and also jobs by lead sources, helping you to identify the most effective sources to gain your customer. In the due dates overview tab, enter how many days ahead you would like to check, for example 30 days, and the tab will show services due in that time. The charts will display upcoming service dates and total potential sales on those dates, and also sales forecast by item for upcoming services. Overdue services tab shows services where the due date has passed but no job was completed. It allows you to follow up with customers who missed their scheduled services. Outstanding invoices tab shows a list of invoices that haven't been fully paid, helping you monitor and follow up on payment. Finally, there is also a built-in invoice generator for you to create an invoice. Simply input your company name and details, select customer name from the drop-down list, Edit the invoice number, invoice date, and payment due date. Choose the item name from the drop-down list and adjust the quantities. The total will be calculated automatically. To export the invoice as a PDF, go to File, select Download, and select PDF. Click Export to export the file in PDF format. So that's all for this tutorial on the recurring service and sales tracker. This spreadsheet is perfect for businesses offering recurring services. It helps to track job history, monitor service due date, manage customer payments, and summarize performance and forecasts. It's a great tool for improving customer follow-up, planning ahead, and growing your business. If you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing for my channel for more tools and tips to help grow your business. Thanks for watching until the end, and I will see you in the next video.